So right now, as you guys know, as residential cryptocurrency miners looking for some passive income, it's not a great time to have your graphics cards on. We got really, really used to 2021 and 2022, but 2023, not so good. After Ethereum went proof of stake in September of 2022, profitability kind of took a nosedive. So, like many of you, you're probably like me. You have a huge pile of money just sitting around in graphics cards, not mining. However, that's not entirely the truth for me. These cards are actually mining. They're just not mining right now because it's not 9 p.m. In 3 hours' time, almost exactly, these rigs will turn on automatically and they will mine for 12 hours when my off-peak rate is cheap. My off-peak rate here, 7.9 cents US dollar per kilowatt hours after taxes, everything. And that lets me break even or make a small amount. And although I don't sell the crypto for tax reasons, it's better to not show a tax loss. So that's what these are doing. There are a few ways to do that scheduling. HiveOS is the operating system that I run for all of my miners, actually. And there is a function in there where you can issue a command via a schedule, via a tag, using flight sheets and things like that to actually program the BIOS in your motherboard to do what's called a wake alarm. And you can set the number of seconds between the shutdown and the wake up to exactly 12 hours. However, what I do is I program them to shut down 5 minutes ahead of the peak switch, and I use, oh yes, smart plugs. You read it right. These are Emporia, E-M-P-O-R-I-A brand smart plugs. And this might look like a mess, but this works fantastic. Although this company does not support 240 volt use on these plugs, and I'm sure they won't warranty it, and it probably doesn't comply with the UL regulation, which means I can't recommend you do this, these have been working great for me for over a year and a half. So what you're seeing right here is a trip light 20 amp PDU, which is running on 240 volts through this. I believe it's a L520P, so a 20 amp twist lock connector running into my service panel. And you'll see that running in through a C20 connector. That's feeding power to all of the C13s and the C19s. And those are fed in via these little dongles to a 515. And you're like, okay, what's a 515? The 515 is what you would call a regular North American power outlet. It's a 120 volt plug. However, when it's plugged into a 240 volt PDU or power distribution unit, it's actually feeding 240 volts. And although the semantics aren't necessarily important, these smart plugs use one of those two hot legs, which is 120 volts, and the ground to function. They don't actually reference the ground to the neutral, which is fantastic, which means they don't blow up when you plug them in, which means they do actually work properly because it's able to replace the neutral with L2 or a second hot, and you can run up to 1200 watts RMS through each one of these smart plugs. So what I have these do right now is in the software, the actual iPhone or Android app for Emporia, once these rigs are programmed to shut down at 8:55 p.m., because my off-peak rate changes at 9 p.m., I'll have the smart plugs kick off at 9 p.m. And what I'll have them do is kick on 9 a.m. sharp. And that will actually let the BIOS do its thing when it's programmed to restore after power loss. And I'll kick on the secondary power supply sometimes 30 seconds in advance just to make sure the rigs come up with some air of stability. And that has been phenomenal for these rigs. And it works really, really well if you're using something like a server power supply where you don't really have the option of running an ATX wake alarm command on your mining rig. So something to definitely consider. There's also really, really good metric logging. You can see right here, I actually have my entire PDU on this. So you're viewing right now the real-time power consumption of an Emporia VUE, we'll call it. What the VUE is, and you can see on the side of my panel, there's a small Wi-Fi antenna sticking out of the side there. That Wi-Fi antenna goes to a little white box inside of my circuit panel, and that is a Wi-Fi receiver, which has a bunch of clamp meters on it. So if you've ever used a multimeter, one of those electrical probes, it's got the little clamp at the top. You can hook it around a cord and it'll tell you how much power it's using. Well, the VUE has like 18 of those in it, and it's able to track every single circuit as well as the main two splits of the entire single phase of 240 coming into your home. And that's what the VUE is. So right now we're drawing 8.3 watts, which is absolutely nothing. However, we can see that all of the PSUs are off as well. And what you're seeing right here with these little power symbols is actually each one of those smart plugs. So if I were to turn those on, and these are nested in the app, so I've told it that basement office is under the garage meter, it will actually give you the percentage of your total power consumption that's coming from that individual smart plug. And you can keep track of, okay, well, how much power is that used this month? And it'll say, well, you've used 237 kilowatt hours and your peak was 859 watts. So it's really handy. And honestly, those plugs, you buy them in a 4-pack and they're less than $40 for four. So really cost effective, even including that little adapter. You're talking about $21 a piece, and it gives you excellent metrics. It lets you remotely power toggle your rig, which I don't know about you, but occasionally I run into an issue, especially with this one, where this 6800 XT does not come up unless I power cycle the rig sometimes. You can do that with the smart plugs. So I took a chance agreeing to sacrifice one of those plugs if it blew up by trying to see if it would run on 240 6 months ago, and it does. They've worked phenomenally well for me since then, and in conjunction with the VUE, which is the main panel component, I am elated. I'm not paid by Emporia. I'm not sponsored by them. They've never contacted me. I pay full price for all that product. There's nothing there. I just want to say that, like, this solution right here combined with the BIOS lets you use really cheap, efficient power supplies. And it gives you another layer of control, because if you have HiveOS and you have a rig problem and your rig hangs, you have no choice but to drive to your rig or get somebody else to go physically to it and unplug it and plug it back in. But if you have an internet connection, which you need for mining anyway, you can power toggle the whole thing from home for $10. And it doesn't cost you anything per month to run these. So like I said, I really, really like this product, and I think this solution, although it looks a little ghetto, it's a lot cheaper than one of those Eaton or APC PDUs, which has built-in relays and power monitoring and requires proprietary software, whereas I can just pull it up on my phone and be like, oh, okay, yeah, what did this rig use today? Well, it was 102 kilowatt hours for the month, 310 watts. No biggie. Working great. Overclocks are still in place. So that's honestly the gist of how I schedule almost all of these rigs. There's only one type of rig that I really do use the wake alarm for, and that's Octominers. These have redundant power supplies, and once you've put the battery in the motherboard, which they don't ship with, I just issue a command at 9 p.m., and it tells the BIOS to shut the computer down and count to, like, 12,400, whatever the number is in seconds, and then power back up. So those work perfectly without it, and they have really accurate power monitoring, so I don't need to run it through one of those plugs. But when you're running a more homebrew rig like this, it's kind of nice, and you always get kind of a litmus test for how inaccurate the software power reading is for your rig in HiveOS. So like these AMD rigs right here, they draw 1300 watts a piece, 12 cards each, and the software says they draw like 1140. So you know that there's a disconnect there, but you can keep track exactly. Like this 1000 watt power supply is pulling like 840, that 600 is pulling 380. We're good. There's no problem there. So it's just another layer of information that you can use to, you know, deduct your taxes on power or make sure your power supply is okay on the actual power rating. Make sure you're not exceeding the 80% rule. There's only one real issue, and that's not even really that big of a problem, but these are 15 amp smart plugs, but they won't let you run more than 1200 watts for 15 minutes a day. Otherwise, they will shut down. So you have to keep it under 1200 to keep them active all the time. Not a big deal, and honestly, that's kind of the smart way to do it, because 1200 watts is the 80% rule for 15 amps. I think that's brilliant. I've only smoked one of these from the power load, and it was in a very, very hot environment. It took over a year, and it failed internally. It didn't catch on fire or anything like that, but it's worth mentioning that they are limited to 1200 watts, whether you're on 120 or 240 volts. They only get warm on 120, not on 240. But I mean, again, I gotta say, it's a great product. It's really, really handy for an extra layer of granular control. It's really good for, bookkeeping, taxes, end of year. And then again, if some of these are 50 miles away from you, it can save you 100 miles round trip. You know, you're going to bed, you're checking your rigs, and one's down. I'm like, oh, great. What do I do? You know, do I do that 100 mile round trip, or do I just toggle it in the software and away you go? So I haven't seen anyone else cover the Emporia hardware before. I have heard a few people talk about it in the Misfit Mining live streams, but nobody's actually covered it yet. And again, since the fact that these are not officially supported on 240 volts, I figured I would at least put this out there so you guys could know that this does seem to function. And again, for the record, I'm not telling you to do the thing that I'm doing, because this is well beyond the design specification of these smart plugs. But I am personally saying that I am doing this, and I have had personally pretty good luck with it. So anyway, those are my two and a bit home rigs here, and that's how I schedule these to not lose a ton of money by only taking advantage of the really cheap power autonomously. So anyway, there's a ramble fest, but thank you again for watching. Hopefully that was interesting. I'll see you for the next video.